food's falling off trees and rotting on the sidewalk, then we're missing a big opportunity to help each other.
I'm often asked who my heroes are, and my answer always surprises people. They are the ordinary people who I meet every day, who are quietly and selflessly doing extraordinary things to make the world a better place. These people do not seek praise or our attention, but I think they deserve both. Welcome to Everyday Heroes.
Hi, my name is Army Linderborg, and I live in San Pedro, California, with my two little girls, 2 and 4, and my husband and our 200-pound dog. When I bought our house, it came with a lemon tree, a guava tree, a kumquat tree, and a little banana grove. And I was thrilled that the house came with free food, but then I quickly realized it was way more than I could consume, or even every single person I knew could consume. So since I moved here, it's been like my mission to find all the fruit trees that are producing and make sure that food gets eaten and doesn't go to waste.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good.
You're here to pick?
Yeah, I'm double
down. Look at you. I guess you're ready, huh?
Yeah.
Fully equipped.
Thank you so much. These are the best. And then, the Garden Church downtown on 6th Street, uh-huh. Those Sundays they give meals out to anyone who's hungry, so all your mulberries are going to go to them today.
Oh, isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
I'm glad to know they'll be used.
I knew that there were homeless or just hungry people everywhere who needed to eat, and we had all this food going to waste. There's a local farm called the Garden Church, and they have a nonprofit called Feed and Be Fed Farm, and every week on Sundays they host a community meal, so they asked me to start bringing some fruit.
The whole COVID thing closed my office down where I work at. I'm in the process of getting unemployment, but I haven't received it yet.
Oh.
And it's just crazy, you know, what's going on. And I appreciate you guys being here so much. Thank you.
And then also, they're doing grocery bags, like produce bags for seniors, so they don't have to go to the store.
So today, we can obviously put this really beautiful grapefruit. And then, what are these? Tangerines?
Mm-hmm.
Put some tangerines in there. And then a lemon for good measure. And so that would be a pretty good bounty that we would take to someone.
If everyone looked through their neighborhood and found, you know, just one orange tree and knocked on the door in a nice neighborly way and, you know, to see if that person wanted to share, we could all be sharing. I've been pushing this agenda for 5 years now since I got this house. Like, we have all this food. We have all this fruit. Like, pick it, trade it, pick it, trade it. Please, do it.
For years, we've walked by. They've been all over the sidewalk, and nobody gets them. And I just thought, they must be really crummy fruit. But it's a shame that they're going the way.
Delicious.
I mean, I think that is something we should teach our children, like the value of harvesting too, you know? Like the ability to climb a tree and pick your own snack is a lot better than like rip it open a wrapper.
1, 2, 3. Oh, you did it!
That's what I want. Less waste, more trade, lots of fruit.
Let's see this beautiful food. Oh my god.
Okay, I need to see. Where have you been?
Picking mulberries.
You have mulberries?
Yeah.